Armoniki, Doshiga, Masurgan Kurabe.
Yo me comencé en New Fiji, Napa.
Casi toda una vida, nosotros somos tercera generación.
Ahora, Masurgan, Uleta, Gagana, Ekavisa, Haror, Vedana. Mi Haru, Diraji, Masurgan Kurabe, Gotu. Ahora, mi Masurgan, Amogati, Regan.
600 embarcaciones, más o menos.
Si el palacio obviamente en el fofo lo solvió, no se hace mal.
People have relied on the oceans as a source of food and for their livelihoods for thousands of years. As technology has advanced, we have become capable of fishing more intensively. So looking after the oceans and the resources they provide is more important now than ever before. If the oceans are to be healthy, productive and full of fish in the future, we have to fish sustainably. Sustainable fishing reduces environmental impacts, leaves more fish in the sea and harms fewer marine animals. Sustainable fisheries have good management practices. The Marine Stewardship Council standard allows fisheries to show that they are well managed and that they fish in a sustainable way. The MSC uses its blue eco-label to identify seafood that has come from sustainable fisheries certified to its standard. The eco-label is already displayed on tens of thousands of products in over 100 countries around the world. Consumers who want to play their part in maintaining and improving the health of the oceans can look for and choose seafood with a distinctive blue MSC eco-label. The MSC standard is open to all fisheries that would like to be recognised as sustainable. To be certified as sustainable, a fishery must be able to meet all three principles of the MSC standard. The fishery must leave enough fish in the sea so that stocks can reproduce and fishing can go on forever. Fishing operations need to be managed so that the wider marine environment, other plants, animals and habitat, can flourish and support life. The fishery must have good management in place. It is vital that we safeguard the ocean's resources and protect people's livelihoods for the future. To do this, we need to work together. In this film, we're going to look at how the MSC is working with three particular fisheries. In the Gambia, which is working towards MSC certification. A fishery in Mexico, which was recertified in 2011. And a fishery in the Maldives, which was certified in 2012.
An organization here called GAMFIDA, the Gambia Artisanal Fisheries Development Agency, expressed interest that the MSC comes here and look at what we are doing here to get some of our fishery certified.
This pre-audit was done. I think that is the first step. The pre-audit was very good for Gambia because it will tell you what state you are, at what level you are, and they identify gaps. I think it was 9 areas. So we developed an action plan to address these 9 areas. This is how we started.
In the Maldives, we first underwent initial assessment phase, and qualifying for that, what it meant was a very detailed assessment and study of how we do fishing, how the data is being collected, what sort of research we do.
We started the process, and halfway through, we have to stop it because there was no skipjack stock assessment done in Indian Ocean.
Well, the biggest improvement that we have to make as far as skipjack is concerned is to improve the stock assessment work.
But Maldives have been collecting fisheries data since 1956, and based on that data, skipjack stock assessment was done, and then we restarted the full assessment.
The case of the lobster fishery here in Mexico, the region that is certified by the MSC has been with a lot of control because of the fishing cooperatives are very well organized, which is really important when you want to really develop a sustainable fishery.
Es muy importante la participación tanto de los productores como los comercializadores, debido a que todos los intereses confluyen o concuerdan en el momento en que se vea la conservación como un negocio.
You have several ways of doing fisheries, from artisanal fisheries all the way through really heavy industrial fisheries. And MSC has been adapting its system in order to take into consideration all this variety of fisheries.
Our biggest challenge was trying to meet the cost of certification. The funds are provided by the government and the people of the United States of America. So of course you also have the University of Rhode Island. They have been sending their experts here, are working with us, and Coughlin decided that they were going to contribute 25,000 euro towards this. Then there was another 25,000 euro earmarked to go as direct support to the fishing communities. Coughlin, the World Wide Fund for Nature, the University of Rhode Island, all these are important partners in our drive to get the fisheries sustainable.
It's just a matter of not doing it single-handedly, but only we can do it collectively.
The government was very keen to take the Maldives pole and line fishery for a global recognition, and hence the government supported the whole cause.
The government and the private sector, the fishing industry, have worked together along the way in terms of the technical support that is required, in terms of providing the data, and in terms of the commitment that need to be given to ensure that MSC certification is continued on.
During the first certification, as far as I know, the government was interested to have a fishery certified.
The government has supported this process by providing the scientific information through a research program along the west coast of the Baja California.
The benefits by getting certified from the point of the industry is that there has been recently a high sense of recognition. People are interested, buyers are interested.
There is the scope for a higher value to be obtained for the Maldivian fish product. This means that the benefit gets transferred to the local fishermen.
We have been getting a premium which we have been passing on to the fishermen, and their health education is being taken care of.
Entonces, pues ha habido ahí beneficios muy interesantes ahí, o sea, por ejemplo, antes nosotros suministrábamos lo que era luz, agua, los servicios básicos.
Después del proceso de certificación, esta distinción internacional les da un poder de negociación y de gestión ante las autoridades mexicanas, atendiendo las demandas que por muchos años se habían hecho por este tipo de servicios básicos.
La verdad que están, pues está muy claro que es muy diferente ahorita a como era antes.
All this biological, social, economic are all contained in the environment. So any injustice you do on any of those areas, you are really directly affecting the environment.
Along the coast, we have identified this area for breeding ground of different fishes coming here during seasonal breeding periods.
We call them spar buoys. Are there as indicators for people to know that from where the buoy ends to the onshore is a no-go zone. There's an area closure beginning from May to October each year to conserve and get this stock regeneration.
To achieve the sustainability in the lobster population is very important because it guarantees the long-term catch for the fishermen.
Ahí lo único que pasa es que hay que regresarla con mucho cuidado al mar, ¿no? Es una langosta que pues está llena de huevecillos y que hay que cuidarla mucho porque eso pues nos va a generar. Es parte del o de ahí donde nace el tema de la sustentabilidad, pues hay que cuidar esa parte para tener un buen futuro, o sea, ahí no hay de otra. ¿Qué pasa? Se regresa al mar.
It is very important to have an eco label, and MSC is one of the most recognized labels by the industries and the retailers. MSC certification is not just a seal on your product. I believe it's something more than that. It takes your fishery to another level. It helps you to keep the fishery managed, sustained, have areas of scrutinization to make the fishery more developed, and helps you to sustain it for generations to come.
We are dealing with a resource. It has to be managed. It has to be sustainably managed. Otherwise, it will not be there for our future generation to use.
When it comes to the pollen line skipjack fishery, those who deserve the benefit most is our local fishermen, because their century-old practices and the efforts that had been put by them that has made us to achieve this certification.
This needs to pass on to other generations the way that it has been passed on to them by their forefathers.
Sustainable fisheries is our responsibility. We have to care for it, for the future.